This is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I want to take a look at the 14 site grow system from Leinnus. All right, so I recently reviewed a 10 site system from the same company, and this is the 14 pod, 14 grow site version. I'll go ahead and point out some things I've noticed without even opening it up yet, but it looks like it's got some of the older design with the some of the other systems I've seen, like the hood attaches in the center. Not a huge fan of, but so it's 14 grow sites, 5 liter capacity, which is a bit larger than the other one I've got. It's like I think 4 liter. It's right at a gallon. It says it has a 50 watt grow light with 134 LEDs. So I'm going to do some tests to verify that. And it's got an 18.5 inch hood height for the light. And it comes with everything you need except for seeds. It has the grow sponges and baskets and all of that. So yes, let's go ahead and unbox this. We'll take a look. So I've got user manual. I think these are like labels that go over the seed pods. You punch the little centerpiece out for the seed, and that would block algae or block light, which would cause algae. That's pretty cool. Okay, so let's take that off. LED panel. That's how that looks. All the parts are inside here. The grow deck. The sponges and the grow baskets and domes. These are all pretty much the same size or close enough to the AeroGarden stuff, so you could use theirs interchangeably. This power adapter. Looks like the little hood stand. There's that. And there's the water level indicator. And this is probably the nutrients. It's the A and B, so it's a two-part. It'll say on the bottle how much to use of each. You notice both ends have like a little mini plug. One plugs down into the center part, and then other connects to the light hood. And there's a submersible pump. That's how that's wired. I'm not a huge fan of these center mounted systems. I'd rather the light be external to the grow bowl, but as long as you're careful, it should be fine. But I just worry about like filling it water, you know, getting down here. But it looks like the whole base is very well sealed. I don't see a drain hole. The old other one had a drain plug. I don't see that on this one, so it's something to note. Assuming this would be the bottom piece here. You have to pull that separately then. I don't think it matters which way, but that's gonna... Oh yeah, the top has a control panel. So we've got control panel for pump and then, or a power, and then there's the turn the pump on and off. Or I think it runs intermittently, but you could force it on or off with that. And it's got three different growing modes, herbs, vegetables, and flower and fruits. And they probably, I don't know, it may change, affect like which lights they use and also the timing. I'm not 100% sure. So another thing, let me take that out. This is similar to another system, which is another design point I don't particularly like, is the plug-in underneath the grow bowl. It's just awkward, and if you were to move it or have to reach under there and there's water in it, there's risk of spilling it. I just don't like that design, but it is what it is. So that's for this. So plug in right there. And that channel falls up. And water level indicator is right there. And let me put some water in this and we'll turn it on. So I did fill it all the way up. I've got, according to this, 2.5 liters. Yeah, it should be enough to operate. Got a kilowatt meter. Right, so let's turn it on. Pretty interesting. Well, one, it's not doing the full 50 watts, and a couple watts is probably for the pump, so it's probably really a 35 watt light as it's operating. Their tensile system actually was exactly what it was advertised as, but this one's under. But still, you know, all that said, for this small hydroponic system, a 35 watt light is still really good. So it puts it somewhere between, if you're comparing to AeroGarden's, it would put it between like the Bounty Basic and the regular Bounty. The Bounty Basic's 30 watt and the Bounty regular Bounty is 40, the Bounty Elite's 50. So it put it somewhere in between those two. So still a decent light, but it's just not what they're advertising. As you can see, it's very loud, probably because I don't have enough water in it, so I may add some more real quick. Try to get a shot of how the pump is working. That's not good. As you can see, it's like kind of shooting the water out the sides. And some of it's actually spilling on there a little bit. So that's interesting. That's going to do a really good job of aerating the water, because it's exposing the streams of water, exposing the air, and it's recirculating back. So that's actually a good, I would say, a good aeration method. It's just kind of weird. One thing I'd wonder is, like, these four grow sites here, the pods are going to get really soaked, so that might be an issue. I'm going to try growing, I'll make note of that when I'm growing it, growing stuff in it, and see if the plants on this corner are any different. So let me get my par meter and temperature gun. I'll do those tests too. Actually, I'm going to add some water in this really quick so it's not so loud. Right now it's about 4 liters according to this thing. So let me do some par readings with the Apogee Instruments MQ500 sensor. I want to do a video just on this sensor, but it's really handy to have for these kind of things, like testing, you know, your lights and efficiencies and whatnot, but also just for setting the proper light intensity at canopy, because if it's underlit, your plants aren't going to do well. If it's overlit, you risk burning them, and really good to have something like this. And I'm going to bring this, oops. Okay, I forgot I could turn the pump off. That's a lot quieter. Let me get the tape measure too, right back. So the deck to right here is 7.5 inches minus the 1.5 for the sensor. So 7.5, 6. So it's going to be, the measurement's going to be 6 inches from the light to the top of the sensor. Okay, we'll start on this back end here. Okay, I just put it on herb mode. So 156, 181, 58. 88, 213, 87, 89, 189, I'm sorry, 171, 205, 153, 174, 144. So in the corners, it's a little, this back one is, front one here is the weakest. The strongest are here and here, but relatively speaking, they're fairly consistent, because these are like the upper, like 180s, 190s, except for these in the four corners, a little bit less. But for the majority of these are closer to this, to the most intense grow sites, which is just over 200, and that's at 6 inches from the hood to the top of the sensor. And let me just do a quick test on the different grammys. I don't know if that makes a difference. Actually, it does. So that center one, which was like a little over 200, is 225 on vegetable mode versus herbs. And on flower mode, it's 208, 206. Go back to herbs. 209. So you're getting a little more light output on vegetable mode. So that, yeah, 220, 190. Yes, even this one's at 200. So if you want more light, you want to use that vegetable mode. Probably not fair to do temp gun readings right now because it hasn't been on very long, but I can tell that I'm not really feeling anything. There's a little bit of heat in the control panel area. But it's probably, I could do some temp gun readings, but it's not gonna really be anything. I'm gonna set this up. This is all I'm gonna do for this video. But yeah, let me get this set up and go and find a good place for it. And I'll do a follow-up video showing how well the whatever I'm growing is doing in here. Another thing on these kind of, where it plugs into the base, you wanna hold it when you raise it up or else you'll pull the thing out. So that's how those look. So you got a mix of white, red, and blue LEDs. Yep, so that's all the way up. And let me do a quick measurement. Yeah, it said 18 and a half, but from the deck, it's actually 19 inches. So it's a little taller. So you could grow something pretty decent size in that, like tomatoes or peppers or whatever that needs some headroom. And you got a really nice large reservoir. So like one like nice pepper plant or tomato plant probably do really well in this, given the amount of light and the reservoir. So I'm gonna wrap this up. So that's the Leinnus 14 site grow system, hydroponic system. And they sent this to me for free to review. I need to mention that too. Thank you for letting me try that. Hope you like that. Thank you very much for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe.